this video, we're going to figure out how to find the max and the min graphically using the graphing calculator. We're going to take the function f of x equals 2x squared minus 3x plus 10 and find the vertex. We see that this is a quadratic function. The leading coefficient is positive. Remember the leading coefficient, the coefficient of x squared. It's a positive number. So we know this would be a graph that is a parabola that opens up. The vertex will be a minimum. First, we're going to graph that in the calculator. In y equals, we enter the equation 2x squared minus plus 10. We're going to select a viewing window that allows us to see the vertex. Now, since you don't know what the vertex is, you do need to do a little bit of a guessing game on this. I'm going to go ahead and do a negative 10 to 10 on the x's and a negative 10 to the y's. And then I hit graph, and we do see that parabola opening up. I'm trying to find this minimum point, that vertex of the parabola. In the calculator, to do this, you're going to hit second and trace. So that second trace, and you see many options here. One of them is minimum, and we know that the vertex in this case is a. So we're going to select option 3, minimum. When you select option 3, the calculator is going to ask you three questions. The first question it asks is left bound. So remember, your vertex that you're trying to find is here, at the bottom of the graph. Left bound means the left side of that vertex. It wants you to move your cursor to the left side of it. So I hit left, 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 the left arrow button until I'm clearly on the left side of it and press enter. Notice then at the bottom of the screen, the calculator is now asking for a right bound. It wants me to move my cursor to the right side of that vertex and press enter. So I hit right, 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 right until my cursor moves to the right side of the vertex. I'm creating a little vertex sandwich. If you notice on the calculator, there's two little arrows. There's an arrow pointed this way and an arrow pointed the other way, and inside of those arrows is the vertex. You made a little vertex sandwich. The last thing it asks you for is a guess. It wants you to move your cursor kind of close. You're giving it a little seed point to start searching. So if you put your cursor near the vertex, it will start there and begin its search, and it's going to search inside your vertex sandwich to find the minimum point. I press enter. And now, in my calculator, gives a value x is 0.749999 and y is 8.875. Now, in reality, the vertex of this is x equals 0.75, y equals 8.875. It is the point, 0.75, 8.875. So you need to be a little careful here. You notice that my calculator gave me an x value that was very, very close to 0.75, but slightly different. If you performed the same features on your calculator, you probably got something slightly different. And in fact, if I do this again, I'll get something slightly different for the x value. Most of the time, the x value it gives you has a little bit of error in it. It's not using a formula to get this x value. It is getting closer and closer and closer and closer until it says, close enough, here's your answer. So you need to use your own skills and your own understanding of what the vertex is of a quadratic and realize that it's probably not 0.749999875. It's probably 0.75. If you're not sure, you do have the option of pulling out the formula, x equals negative b over 2a, to find the answer. But most of the time, it's pretty obvious. That was 0.749999999. That's 0.75.